would for a moment what Jesus must have been talking about, or what he knew was going on behind his back as they were walking along the road. Think about the apostles for a minute, arguing with each other. Hey, I know more about the Bible than you do. Hey, I think I'm his favorite because I was there when he did this miracle. Or, hey, you know, remember that time when he talked about me being the beloved one? The apostles arguing about who was the greatest among them. Then to make a powerful point, to set them straight, Jesus goes and grabs a little child. And back 2,000 years ago, children would not have had a place among the people like they do today. Children were seen as expendable. They were seen as property. It was only when they got old enough to contribute to the workload, to help with the household, did they take on some value. And so to point out to them and straighten out who's the greatest among them, Jesus takes this tiny, seemingly worthless child to his lap and makes a powerful point. Today, the children sit among us and teach us, just as they did at the time of the gospel lesson. And I'm glad you Sunday school kids are here today, because not too long from now, maybe 10, 15 years from now, you could be sitting here talking about a very similar trip or experience. So I want you guys to listen carefully as they talk about what they did this summer at the National Youth Gathering. It's an opportunity for all of us to grow through their words and experience. So for those of you who have never gone on a National Youth Gathering before, we need to hear a little bit about what it's like to get there. How do you get there? Where do you stay when you're there? What happened on the way home? What was the general experience about? So Emily, can you share that with us?
Sure. So as we left St. Paul's, we left in vans, two of our vans from St. Paul's, and we met up with the Abiding Presence on the Ports along the road. Traveling these vans, before traveling with a small family, everybody in these vans got along. Some were mixed, some were just St. Paul's, and some just Abiding Presence. But we all generally got along in our vans, and you know, it was a great time travel-wise. And our first overnight stay was at a home with this couple that let us in, all of us. And they welcomed us into their home, they fed us dinner, we hung out until like 9 o'clock, maybe not 9 o'clock, but fairly late at night. So we played games, we had fun, and then they invited us to their church, and we slept in their church overnight. And when we woke up the next morning, they had breakfast for us. Their hospitality was beyond amazing. They took very well care of us children and the adults too, chaperones. Then as we got to Detroit, we stayed in the hotel, span of the days we were there. And they fed us when we got back from our long day. They had snacks waiting for us. You know, we were taking snacks, but it was still food when we got back from our day of service. And we generally had a great time. The hotel was beautiful. You know, we all had a great time spending time with each other in the rooms. And on our way home, we went to Cedar Point in Ohio, which is a pretty amazing adventure park, boat rivers and everything. And we stayed in a hotel that had a built-in water park as well. So, you know, the travel was great. Everybody had like, their own mini family in their own way. We all had a great time.
Thank you, Emily. A national youth gathering like this with our larger church body happens every 3 years. So tell us exactly what happens when the whole church gets together on occasion like this. And David's going to speak for his brother Mike.
Well, the ELCA comes together as a formal program for the youth gathering. Took place each evening at Ford Field, which is the Detroit Lions Stadium where the Super Bowl was hosted. So over 25,000 Lutheran kids and chaperones all over the country, New York, Minnesota, California, all over, heard inspirational speakers and Christian bands each night, including some bands that played Motown classics, which was fitting because we were in Detroit. But during the day, we went on to some of the construction stuff, like the Ford Field tour we went on, and then we also ate at Soul Foods and walked around Greentown.
most surprising thing that you discovered while you were in Detroit, Brenna?
Prior to the gathering, there's a lot of questions regarding the safety of Detroit. And when we got there, we realized that it's not as scary as people might think. Actually, some of you groups didn't come to Detroit because it was held in Detroit. It was amazing to see how much Detroit had recovered and cleaned up.
While you were in Detroit, there was a day of service. Tell us about that day, Hunter.
All right, so we woke up fairly early. I think it was like 7 o'clock. The game plan was to get out early. That's early for me, some of you guys are probably a little late, but the game plan was to get up early, go out, spend some time at, we were going, hello? So our job was to go to a fire department and we were gonna help build picnic tables for the firemen. But unfortunately, there was a bump in the road. There was a tragic accident on the main highway, which there was tragic death or something. So it took us a while to get out. But after a while we got out, we went to the fire department. They showed us around, there was an older fire department actually that burned down a year before. So after showing us around, then proceeded to build the picnic tables, which of course, picnic tables doesn't seem like a huge help, but to these guys it really was. And then once we finished that, we had a lot of time left over, and we saw the alleyway next to them. So the alley was it was filthy. There was garbage everywhere. It was a long process, probably like 2 hours, but we cleaned it up. And to some of the firemen, probably wasn't a big deal, but to the chief, that was just the one thing he wanted his firemen just to take care of the place, and some of them did. So us cleaning it up just made the guys dead.
There was a lot of personal growth on this trip. How did you grow personally, Bella?
Before the trip, I was really shy, and as we spent more time in Detroit and met more people, I was able to push myself out and become more shy.
Thank you. While you were in Detroit, you had a special privilege during the closing service. Mackenzie, why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Okay, so the last day on a Sunday, we had a huge church service with 30,000 people, and our New York Synod was chosen to give communion to 30,000 people. So I was the person that had to do the anointing, which is you get oil, and you put your thumb in the oil, and then you draw a cross on people's head with oil. So at first, people don't really do the anointing normally with communion, so people were like, why are you grabbing my head and putting oil on me? They didn't really know what I was doing. And then, once people started seeing me doing it.
You're good.
Detroit. So Megan Cheshire, who's attending Western Kentucky University, wrote, this summer I was fortunate enough to go to Detroit for the ELCA National Youth Gathering. It was an amazing experience getting to go with our youth group, but also with the youth from a vital presence. When we got to Detroit, we were welcomed to the city, and we're soon known as the Skittles because of all of our colorful t-shirts. You see some of them in front of you now. The first night was amazing. Watching the stadium fill up with other Lutherans was breathtaking. You could feel the presence of God that week. For Sunday morning service, our synod was given a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to help serve communion to around 30,000 Lutherans. I am so blessed that I was able to take part in this gathering. This one was by far my favorite because I took part in the Sunday service and made some amazing memories with some amazing people. I am also so grateful for all the support of our congregation. This trip would not have been possible and would not have been so meaningful without your support and prayers. With all that said, I cannot wait to go to the next gathering in Houston, Texas in 2018. Thank you, Megan Cheshire. Lindsay Burns is attending SUNY Buffalo. You saw pictures of Lindsay in the video getting her hair cut. She was donating 12 inches of hair to one of those, not Locks for Love, but one of the other ones. And so she came back totally different looking when she came back. And she wrote, "If I were to tell you one word about Detroit, I couldn't do it. There were too many feelings and so much to do there. One word wouldn't be enough to describe the fun and experiences I had. I was able to reconnect with an old friend and able to meet new ones along the way. It was an adventure where I learned a lot. I cannot wait to go again." And finally, Katie Grant, who's attending Slippery Rock University. "Detroit was nothing like everyone says. It has its good areas and bad areas, but it's not all bad. There were so many Lutherans in one place, all coming together and working on common goals. Gathering each evening for praise with 30,000 of us was amazing. We had a great deal of fun, plus not having to explain what being a Lutheran means was even better. I am so glad Lindsay and Emily talked me into going." So as you can see and as you can hear, this was an incredible life-changing experience. These are once-in-a-lifetime opportunities. I remember back in 1986, I participated in a national youth gathering in Washington, D.C. My favorite part was all the free time that I had to look at all the monuments and the museums of Washington, D.C. But I do remember and cherish the time we spent together with the youth in the gathering. And so each of these young people, leaders in our church, have had this opportunity to be blessed and to be a blessing to others, and we thank God for that. And we thank God for your support in making this happen. So I think it's appropriate that we show our appreciation to God and to these, our young people, our young witnesses, with a round of applause.
Bishop was with us, so we got to spend some time with Bishop Bimbo, so it's a great experience.